Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today I'm going to show you the new updates for the SaaS pricing plans and how you can create new plans using different currencies using the SaaS Configurator. So let's get started. Step one, create a new category. To start, you need to be on your agency settings on the SaaS Configurator. You will see different categories by default. We have the default category, which is where the existing plans were created. To create a new category, we can click this button here that says Categories and add a new category. We can now select a different currency depending on our category. So let's say we want to sell some SaaS plans in Mexico, so we can select the Mexican peso as our currency and we can enter a category name. In this case, I'm going to enter Mexico. We can now click here where it says Save. Our new category has been created, but as you can see, we have no plans on that category, so let's fix that. Step 2, Plan Creation. We can click here on the top right button where it says Add Your Plan Here. And I'm going to name this, for example, Mexico Standard. As for the description, you can put whatever you want here, but I'm just going to leave it as Mexico Standard and click Next. We can select any category we want from the ones we have created. I'm going to select the Mexico category that is on Mexican pesos. So here is the category name. Here is the currency we are going to be using. So I'm going to use the Mexican pesos. And here, where it says, where do you want to place the plan? So for example, in the default, I already have some plans created. We can put it between the professional and the premium. This is the one we just created, so we can have it set up however we want. It's the only one there, so it's going to be at the top. I can click Next. Step 3, remaining steps. Here we can set up the price for the monthly plan. So for example, I can say it's going to be 5,000 pesos a month. And for the yearly, I can say it's going to be 50,000 because I want to give them 2 months free if they pay for it annually, right on the yearly subscription. I can also set a user limit. I can set it to any number of users I want. By default, it's 50, but I can set it to 12. If I turn this off, it's going to be unlimited users. So if you want, that's something you can control. That's up to you. And it's the exact same thing for the contact limit. You can set it up so it has different contacts, so they can only have at most, let's say, 500 contacts. This I don't suggest you have on because you are limiting the amount of clients they can have on the platform. But if that's something you want to control, you have the option there. We can click Next to go to the next step. This is what you will be offering with the plan, right? So two-way text and email conversations, web chat, Facebook messages. The ones that have the lock icon at the top are the ones that you cannot turn off. But anything that doesn't have the lock, you can either give them access to them or not, so you can turn them on and off as you want. So for example, let's say I don't want them to have blogs, campaigns, reporting, triggers. I can choose whatever I want. And then I can click on Next. I can also set it up so they can have a trial period where they will not be charged, so I can set it up to 30 days if I want. If I set it to 0 days, that means there's no trial period. In this case, let me turn it up to 15 days. That's usually enough for them to get a feel for the plan. Now, I can also add credits that are given when signing up on the plan. So this will give them one-time credits, or they can have recurrent credits every month so I can set them up however I want. So they have 5 credits every month, or just when they sign up, they have, let's say, $10 credit, right? Or you can set it up so they don't have any credits. I'm going to click Next, and then I can do phone rebilling, so I can set it up to 1.05, all the way up to 10 times the charge for phone rebilling. And let's say I want to charge twice as much as it's costing me. I can also set up reselling for email, triggers and actions, email verification, content AI, workflow AI, conversations, and reviews. And I can set it up as high as I want, right? All the way to 10 times the price. And when I feel I'm okay with my plan, I click on finish. And it's been saved. So if I take a look here, this is the name of the plan. This is all the options that I selected for it. It has the price on Mexican peso. It's also on the Mexican peso category, right? I hope this video helped you to set up different currencies in the SaaS Configurator. See you next time.